No doubt that intrauterine adhesions, Usherman, is the most challenging hysteroscopic surgery, especially when there is a complete obliteration of the uterine cavity with the frustrating hysterography showing zero cavity. Let's go together into a uterine cavity completely obliterated by adhesions. Meanwhile, I will disclose to you all the tips and tricks and maneuvers to overcome the extensive adhesions. Here we are just starting at the level of the internal os. There is white, dense vascular adhesions. You can see the minute blood vessels. So pushing the telescope with gentle forward pressure, guided by the hydrodissection force. So here there are two forces together. Please don't just say it hydrodissection. It's a deliberate, gentle push. While you are pushing, your hands get a feedback resistance of the tissues. How you learn that? By experience, by repeating and trials and trials. So here I can feel resistance which is yielding under push. Okay, so your nerve sensors should differentiate between the resistance of fibrous tissue and the myometrium and the dense fibrosis. So as you see here, there is a gradual release, open up of the adhesions as if going from darkness to light, from desert to green. Look at that. Look at that. Please appreciate the gradual release of adhesion. Again, I repeat, it is absolutely feedback sensation you get when you are driving your telescope. So you can obviously see that a space is created, but it's all lined by white color tissues. This white tissues is in fact is a weak atrophic endometrium. Same like the green grass deprived from the water, it turns brown. So look here, there is a landmark, there is a clue. Yes, this black spot signify that this is a tubal ostium and the cornea. So identification of an anatomical landmark help you to know when to stop, because if everything white and you don't have a landmark and you keep pushing, you can easily go through the myometrium, through the serosa, and you can see the bowels, and that's an undesired complication. So this is one tubal ostium identified. I take it now as a landmark. Try to search on the opposite side for the other ostium. Stay tuned and see the beautiful scissors maneuver to search and find the other ostium. For dense fibrosis, here hydrodissection is not enough. Look at the movement of the scissor blades, searching, and yes, this black hole identify the location of the other tubal ostium. You can confirm that by coming close, and you can see here the endosalpinx epithelium. So this is the most happy moment for the hysteroscopic surgeon in an Usherman surgery. Reaching both ostia, which means that you created the cavity and expanded the space to the maximum dimensions. Now, this white endometrium is ready to receive support, either by hormones or whatever, to help regrow of that weak atrophic endometrium. So, my dear friends, I hope you enjoyed these steps and my tips and tricks to overcome the nightmare of Usher. And look at the endometrium. It starts to be pinkish now. Let me share with you the result of surgery. That's before and that's after surgery. My dear friends, thank you very much. This is Usama Shawki from Cairo, Egypt.